Good afternoon, everyone, Your Excellencies, Ministers, members of the Scottish Parliament, members of the Consular Corps, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of all members of the Scottish Parliament, I'm pleased to welcome His Excellency John Dramani Mahama, the President of the Republic of Ghana, and the First Lady, Her Excellency, Madam Lordina Mahama, to the Scottish Parliament. Welcome. Now, I know, Your Excellency, that you have a very busy programme for your visit, so we're incredibly grateful that you took time from your schedule to be here to address members of the Scottish Parliament. I also know that you will receive an honorary degree of Doctor of Laws from Aberdeen University tomorrow morning, and for that I would like to offer congratulations on behalf of the Scottish Parliament. It's fitting, I think, that you're visiting us this week as we celebrate Commonwealth Week, with events being held across the Commonwealth to mark Commonwealth Day, which took place a couple of days ago on the 14th of March. And it's fair to say that the Scottish Parliament is a proud member of the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association, and our members very much welcome the opportunities that this membership brings to build relationships and work closer with and learn from our colleagues in other parliaments. So I very much hope that you enjoy your time here in Scotland and in our Scottish Parliament. Thank you very much. Can I now invite His Excellency to address the meeting, please? Thank you.
Thank you very much, Right Honourable Deputy Presiding Member. I want to thank you for the privilege to be with you in Holyrood, and thanks to for the honour done myself and my wife to observe the First Minister's question time for the first time. The question time attests to the long-standing democratic tradition of the United Kingdom within the context of a devolved system of governance. Although we do not run a parliamentary system of governance in Ghana, our parliamentary standing orders makes provision for question time for ministers of state. And having served before as a Minister of Communications, I experienced at first hand the uniqueness of this democratic practice. But I must say it does not come anywhere close to the time-tested tradition of the First Minister or the Prime Minister's question time. Right Honourable Deputy Presiding Officer, Ghana and the United Kingdom have built a very strong bilateral relationship that has transcended our historical colonial past. Our relations have grown over the years, nurtured by strong people-to-people contacts, a dynamic diasporan community, regular high-level visits, and significant economic ties. I'm therefore positive that my visit to Scotland could further strengthen these relations and see the exploration of even new areas of trade and investment between us. This is a country that has over the years led the world in heavy industries such as steel, shipbuilding, coal mining, and also in oil and gas. Ghana has, under my administration, been on a quest to diversify the base of our economy. This is aimed at transforming us from a primary commodity exporter and import-dependent economy into an export-led, value-added one. In this journey of transformation, Scotland provides us with a good opportunity for collaboration in developing our manufacturing sector. We've already established an impressive collaboration in developing our human resource and management capacity in the oil and gas industry. A growing number of the personnel working in our fledgling oil and gas sector received their training here in Scotland. Since 1926, when Scotland received its first Ghanaian student, many of your institutions of higher learning, including the University of Glasgow, Dundee, and Aberdeen, have continued to provide professional training to many Ghanaians. One of the greatest signs of our cooperation and friendship is the Scotland-Ghana Society, which sprang out of the large number of teachers, doctors, scientists, and missionaries who worked in the then Gold Coast and returned here to Scotland. I'm happy to be returning to the Scottish Parliament after the visit in the year 2000 by President Gerry John Rawlings. Let me use this opportunity to express the appreciation of Ghanaians to the University of Glasgow for the recognition they gave President Rawlings during his visit, and subsequently the Asantehene Otumfo Osaitutu II, who were both awarded honorary Doctor of Law degrees. Ghana has played a prominent role in the affairs of our continent, from the process of decolonization to the formation of the OEU, the process of continental integration to the significant success in implementing the Millennium Development Goals. It is my determination to continue this tradition in maintaining Ghana as a model of democracy and constitutional governance in Africa. We will work to deepen the process of regional integration and ensure the free movement of people and goods across the region. Africa is an emerging continent with a fast-growing population. We are therefore a continent in a hurry. A ticking youth bulge requires that we speed up the process of economic growth in order that we can provide decent jobs for the large number of young people graduating from our schools every year. Accelerated economic growth, expansion of manufacturing and agriculture will guarantee jobs and staunch the risky flow of young Africans across the Mediterranean in search of new opportunities in Europe. Ghana will continue to be an advocate and actor in international peace and security on the global stage. We currently have our troops in 5 different international peacekeeping theaters across the world. Our global ranking in governance, human rights, transparency, and rule of law is strong. Ghana has had 6 successive elections since 1992, and this year's election will be no exception in terms of transparency, fairness, and security. The many elections held in several African countries last year sends a clear message that Africa is emerging and building a solid foundation of participatory democracy that will form the basis of guaranteeing a life of dignity and prosperity for our people. In conclusion, let me, on behalf of my co-chair of the SDG Advocates Forum, Prime Minister Erna Solsberg, invite Scotland to join hands with us and other countries of the United Nations to combine resources towards the realization of the UN Sustainable Development Goals. I thank you very much for the honor done me. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency, for that interesting and informative address to Members of Parliament. Can I now invite our Cabinet Secretary for Culture, Europe and External Affairs, Fiona Hislop, MSP, to respond to the address. Thank you.
Your Excellency, President Mahama, First Lady of the Republic of Ghana, ministers and delegates from Ghana, Deputy Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament and members of the Consular Corps. Thank you so much for your address and your presence here in our Parliament today. We're very pleased that you've chosen to visit our country, which can only help deepen the friendship between Scotland and Ghana. I know you have a very busy programme ahead with a visit to Aberdeen University tomorrow, where they'll host a special honorary degree ceremony in your honour. Your visit is particularly pertinent, as we've heard, given that Commonwealth Day was celebrated 3 days ago on the 14th of March, with both Scotland and Ghana part of this family of nations. The Commonwealth values of humanity, equality and tolerance are universal. And of course, we hosted the Commonwealth Games in 2014 and recognised the part that Ghana played in the success of the event. As well as the success of the initiatives such as Scotland House, Pride House and the Legacy Programme, which aims to ensure benefits of the Games are shared by all. Scotland has always been an outward-looking nation. We want to build links and strengthen ties with countries right around the world. And we appreciate that Scottish economic success will be realised through strengthening our links with the global economy and the opportunities this brings for increasing trade, attracting investment and sharing expertise. Your Excellency, in your inaugural address, you said Ghana should and will be a place where economic opportunities are available to everyone. Here in Scotland, we share the drive for shared economic opportunity. Scotland's economic strategy reinforces our long-term vision for Scotland's economy, which is based on a fundamental principle. By becoming a fairer society, we will also become a more productive and a more prosperous economy. The strategy also identifies internationalisations as an integral strand in helping Scotland build a fairer and more equal society both at home and abroad. And Your Excellency, I know that one of the key purposes of your very welcome visit to Scotland is to look at the strengthening of trade and investment ties. And the Scottish Government took an important step in doing that almost 2 years ago when our International Trade and Investment Agency, Scottish Development International, set up its first office in Africa, working out of the British High Commissions in your country's capital city of Accra. You come here at what are very challenging times globally, across a range of industry sectors, and governments are working hard to ensure the prosperity of their key industries. Your Excellency, I know that you are working hard to try and diversify your own economy away from key commodities and to do what you can to reap the benefits that your small but growing oil and gas industry will bring. And I'm sure that our visitors here today will be aware of the history of the development of the North Sea and the global oil and gas energy centre that is Aberdeen. And whilst we, like you, are inevitably feeling the impact of the lower oil price, we do so from a position of some strength. Strength from our people who have developed and helped bring innovation to the industry over the almost 50 years that we've had exploration and production. Strength from our companies who have adapted and improved the way business has been done in the sector. And strength from our institutions, who continue to build the framework to enable business in Scotland to flourish, for example, the Oil and Gas Technology Centre in Aberdeen. So sharing knowledge, information and technology is vital in that regard. Local content is quite rightly of crucial importance, and no more so than in Ghana. So international companies recognise the importance and mutual benefit of local content and participation. And they want to see that effort they put into training people benefit both the company and the individual they have trained in the future ahead. So forging partnerships between foreign and local entities help build on each other's strengths in pursuit of business. And we in Scotland look forward to helping to grow and encourage greater collaboration between our companies to mutual benefit in this important sector. And as the connections between our two countries are not just commercial, but people to people. For example, through academic exchange, such as the University of the West of Scotland's newly established Centre for African Research on Enterprise and Economic Development, and the work taking place at the Centre for African Studies in Edinburgh University, one of the world's leading centres of Africa-focused knowledge and research. And those people-to-people connections are strong through the members of the Ghanaian community who have chosen to make Scotland their home. So I'll close on that note, Your Excellency. Listening to your address gave me a renewed appreciation of the depth of the relationships that are being forged between our two countries. And we look forward to many more years of partnership between our two nations, Scotland and Ghana. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Can I once more warmly thank His Excellency John Dramani Mahama and the First Lady, Mrs. Lordina Mahama. I understand it's your first visit to Scotland, and I do hope it will not be your last. Can I also thank Fiona Hislop, our Cabinet Secretary for Culture, Europe and External Affairs, for her response to the address, which covered many areas of mutual interest. Thank you very much for that response, Cabinet Secretary. Once again, Your Excellency, I really hope you enjoy your time here in the Scottish Parliament and also the rest of your visit to Scotland. Thank you very much. Thank you.